Do you feel anxious or worried just before an important event, even though you have prepared for it completely? And when you share this feeling with someone, all they reply is, "Don't worry." But here, problem is that you don't stop to worry. And if you are someone like me, then you will begin to worry even more. Hey guys, welcome to When to Read What. And we humans generally start to worry when our mind starts thinking about the problems which might occur during an event, and we try to think that how we are going to counter it. So here, let me share with you a personal example. So for my entire life, I have always felt butterflies in my stomach just before any examination. And it was because I used to think about the most difficult question which I had studied for that particular exam. And so on, I used to think about the second most difficult question, then third most difficult question, then my mind would start thinking about how I am going to solve those questions if they ever come in examination. And like this, I would fall in a loop of worries, which would result into small anxiety. So is there a way to get out of this trap? Well, I have discovered a simple but effective technique which really helps me to calm down. And origin of this technique is from one of the greatest book which is ever written on emotions, which is Emotional Intelligence, written by Daniel Goleman. And in the book, Goleman sir has taken reference from a famous psychologist, Mr. Thomas Brokovic, and has discussed a process which Mr. Brokovic uses on his patient to break the loop of anxiety or worries. So this process is majorly divided into three parts, in which the very first part is self-awareness. So the very first step in this entire process is that you need to become self-aware that you have already begun to become anxious or worried regarding something. And the key point here to keep in mind is that you need to catch the worry or anxiety as soon as possible, because as the time passes by, the anxiety or the worry begins to grow. And now coming to the second step of this entire process, which is to use a relaxation method. So in the second step, you need to calm down your nerve. And here I use a very powerful breathing technique, which is known as 448 breathing technique. So in it, you need to inhale for first 4 seconds, then hold your breath for another 4 seconds, and then exhale your breath for another 8 seconds. So if you guys want to try this method, then you can pause the video and try it right now. Remember to inhale for 4 seconds, then hold your breath for another 4 seconds and exhale your breath for another 8 seconds. So now once you have calmed down your nerve, then it is time to move towards the third step, which is to take a critical stance. So in this step, you need to think about what's the probability of this particular event happening in the future. So in my case, I used to think about the probability of the most difficult question arriving in the examination. And if the probability was really low, then I used to stop worrying right there. And if the probability was high, then I used to think about what was the maximum weightage which could be allotted to that particular question. And it has never happened in my entire life that I got failed in an examination just because of one single question. So this is how, following this particular procedure, I feel much better regarding any anxiety or the worry which I am feeling at that particular moment. But I have also improvised this technique by adding one more step to this entire process, which I call Batista bomb the problem. So if you are wondering what does Batista bomb problem means, so let me tell you, in my childhood, I was a very big fan of WWE, and there was a superstar named as Batista who used to deliver Batista bomb as his finishing move. So here I imagine worry as a person in my mind, and then I deliver the final Batista bomb to that worry and make it disappear forever. So this book talks about almost every emotion which a human being feels during his or her lifetime. And it also tells you why we feel that particular emotion and how we could use it to our advantage. So I had picked this book when I was feeling emotionally drained by anger, anxiety, fear, and whatnot. So at that time, I was feeling emotionally fucked up just because I wasn't able to understand what was wrong with me when everything around me was perfect. So as I read this book, it really helped me to understand my feelings and my emotions better, which really helped me to grow emotionally, and it also helped me to solve my problems. So this book is definitely a very good read for someone who wants to know much more about his or her emotions and also want to manage his or her emotions more intelligently. However, if you're feeling emotionally disturbed or emotionally fucked up, then this book is a must read for you guys. Because this book will give you the required quality of clarity which you will require in order to solve your emotional problems. And here, I would also like to add a disclaimer that I'm not a medical professional or psychologist, and I have only shared the method and my experience while reading this particular book. So I hope you guys like the video. Do share the video with someone who might benefit from it, and please do smash that like button down below. And please do subscribe to When to Read What, and please do press that bell icon so that you get notified whenever I upload some valuable content. And if you are facing any kind of problem, then you can comment it in the comment section down below, or you can directly DM me on our Instagram handle or on our Facebook page. I will definitely try to answer it via help of a book. So until then, happy reading!